I'm going through a weird skater boy. I don't know. And so bear with me because I look like I'm bald. But that's not what matters. Today, I'm gonna do a tiny New York City kitchen tour. This is a part of my kitchen. You'll see the rest of it. And I will show you how the hell we fit three people in this tiny little kitchen and we all cook. And there's a lot of days where we're all cooking at the exact same time with so many groceries, so many chopping boards everywhere. And it's a lot, but it works and it's actually not that bad. It is how many square feet? Let me check. This is gonna be rough, like really rough estimate. It's basically 9 by 11 feet, give or take a few inches, which is actually pretty big for a New York City kitchen. We have a pretty full-size kitchen, so even though I say it's tiny, it's actually huge for New York City. So we have my pears on this cute cutting board. We also have a full working dishwasher, which we don't use for dishwashing. Because we're Asian and we just use it as a dish rack, but it fills up really quickly because there's so many of us. Also guys, look at this freaking mug that I just got yesterday. Stone Street Coffee, and on the side it says serious coffee for serious New Yorkers, and the inside is this blue. I don't know if you can see it. I need to make sure you guys can see it. Like the top part is a gloss and then the actual cup itself is this matte like charcoal, which is so pretty. I've been obsessed with like ivories and like just really strong blues recently, so it caught my eye. I also love this coffee shop, so just grab myself a mug. And we have this toaster oven. It's looking a little it's seen better days. We have a kettle, an espresso machine. It only makes one cup at a time. It does the job. I save a lot of money. Our matcha making set, rice cooker, Mikey's tea, so she has decaf, Earl Grey, and chai. And this is my pistachio syrup. And then this is our massive sink. Look at how big it is compared to my hand. We have everything that we need here for quick cooking. The pepper, salts, vinaigrette, lots of olive oil, avocado oil. I only use avocado, and then canola oil is Mikey's and Tiff's. Spoons and our knife set. Here's our awesome electric oven that takes forever to heat up our food, but at least we have one oven which we bake a lot in. Living in a small New York apartment, super important to take advantage of any storage you can. So we use every part of this kitchen. Nothing is left empty or just minimal. It's literally stuffed. Microwave. We also don't have any circulation in our apartment, and so it can get super smelly, smoky, and stuffy in this apartment. We usually use the fan up here to clean that up. The vent's looking a little gross. And we have this air purifier. It's very expensive, but it cleans up the air and gets rid of like the garlicky smell or whatever smells there are from cooking. This is our fridge. I freaking love this fridge, guys. Our decorations. We have a ton of pictures. Our doggies. This is a screen time competition. We started in the beginning of the year and it's almost freaking done. This is BTS because Mikey loves BTS. And we have a bunch of these really cute elephant magnets. Okay, this is our fridge. It's sectioned off by a roommate. This is Mikey's portion right here. And I get this whole left side right here. And Tiff gets this whole right side right here. This part, we kind of did like each person gets a shelf, but that's kind of not worked out. And we're literally just putting whatever we want anywhere, but we know whose is whose. I'm about to expose my roommate's eggs, her Filipino sauces, Asian soy milk. We're sharing this giant container of kimchi. She has all her veggies. And Mikey has this thing where she gets into fixations. Well, her and Tiff. She is going through like an eggplant squash fixation. And so she's gonna keep making that for a while.
This Tiff's side, bread, a jar of pickles, this mung bean cake. She also has Chinese medicine in the back. Veggie, matzo, cheese, turkey breast. She's going through like a sandwich phase right now, I think. I have chili oil, these grapes. I love both green and red. Dates back there. Vegan, kale, cashew, basil, pesto, which is so yum. Crumbled feta cheese.
I have like this weird collection of milks.
Almond milk, but barista version. I have this Milkadamia barista version. Regular almond milk from Trader Joe's. A bunch of random drinks and sauces. My matcha's in here. Hojicha, QP mayo, hard kombucha, Asian sauces, Angry Orchard, soju, and then this is our freezer.
It's a free-for-all. The freezer, we tried to like split like this three ways, but now it's just turned into wherever you want to put it, you can put it. And I don't get a lot of freezer food.
Mikey and Tiff, they tend to have a lot more.
Like I said, we use literally every single section for storage. So underneath our like storage rack, which is not technically part of our kitchen, is this
rice salt in a big jar, a ton of water bottles, huge glasses of wine for wine-yo. This is the best thing ever. This beef soup comes in packs, canola oil in jugs.
And so even though we live in New York and there isn't that much space, we still manage to order a lot in bulk because we are trying to save money. We just try our best to store it somewhere and make it work. This is underneath our kitchen sink and we have so much stuff in there. But it's really organized. It doesn't look like it, but it is.
There's our recycling bin, cleaning supply. So we put all of our cleaning, trash things, and reusable paper bags in here.
All of our pots. So we have in three different sizes. We have these pans, square shape. Our pans in three sizes as well. Yeah. I'm doing a terrible job of recording this. And also we use upper refrigerator space.
I have a lot of dried stuff up here. Vermicelli noodles, my oat Fruit Loops. Here's this storage unit. It just has a bunch of stuff. It's our baking stuff, our vases, leftover parchment paper because we buy bulk.
Okay, another cabinet which we store all of our baking stuff.
Bag of sugar, protein, randomly. Literally anything you can imagine, we have it up here.
Also, I'm so short, I have to step on a chair whenever I grab anything. So this is what's up here. We split into three like this, and it just has all of our dry things.
Tiff has popcorn, seeds, avocados, some pasta. Mikey's is down the center, where she has peanut butter, tomato sauce, of instant noodles, her caffeine pills. And then on my side, I have cookie butter, Spam, beans, a bunch of snacks. Just got this, and it's so freaking good. But I think Jingle Jangle is a little bit better.
This is my favorite and most used section, and it's the tea and coffee section, where I have literally all my teas here, and my coffee beans, plates, and our mugs, and cups, and glasses, and shot glasses. And so this cabinet has just a bunch of like to-go tumblers.
Random oils and sauces, mainly Asian spices and sauces.
And this is our dining area. I don't know.
And this is our trash can.
Not too exciting, this part. Oh, we also use over the cabinet storage, like up there, guys.
The old dog food, a bunch more paper towels, a good fancy bottle of vodka up there.
I hope you guys enjoyed this very quick, fun, maybe fun kitchen tour of a New York City kitchen in a teeny tiny New York City apartment. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you guys have any other video ideas, then down below. All good things. And yeah, bye.